Black-footed ferrets and white-tailed prairie dogs have a really interesting relationship because black-footed ferrets require the white-tailed prairie dogs as a food source and other prairie dog species as well, but they also use the burrows that prairie dogs create. White-tailed prairie dog populations fluctuate, so they kind of boom and bust over time. So we want to find the most stable populations over the course of a long period, and that's going to be targeted for the black-footed ferret release.
This is the Snake John complex, which is pretty big. Okay, you can drop me off here. I'll do that. We'll go do that.
So the process of collecting data is we have our interns go out and walk transects, usually about 1,000 meters in length.
Did you plan on going through washes today?
I go out looking for prairie dog burrows and if they're active or inactive. The main giveaway usually is fresh droppings. So I'll mark this one as active because there's fresh droppings.
And then she's going to have a GPS unit. She can put a waypoint, it's active, inactive, what transect it is, and she'll go to the next.
It's a lot of these ones look like they've collapsed.
I'm trying to build a bigger picture, a multi-year picture of what these colonies look like. So they're getting hands-on experience out there in the field, and they're collecting real data that's part of a very important project.
Active or inactive?
Active.
It's helped with field experience and kind of that foot in the door opportunity to start meeting people that I might possibly be working for later on.
That's the take home for these kids, is that it's the interaction with the people that I think carries you to the finish line to get a, you know, a full-time permanent job.
We see a lot of students using this position as a stepping stone and using that to jump off into more permanent positions in the future working in the field of natural resource management.